You're watching Tag TV.
From Kashmir to Kanyakumari, India is a spellbinding mosaic of culture, tradition, languages, and an extraordinary mingling civilization. Keeping its age-old culture maintained, today the country is taking huge strides in the path of development. Hello, I'm your host Karim Zimik, and today in our episode of My India, we bring you some of the stories that will give you a glimpse of our country's diversity. Women around the world are proving their mettle in every field by leaving old stereotypes behind and coming out stronger than ever. To honor the valor and perseverance of women and celebrate womanhood, International Women's Day is celebrated on 8th March every year around the country in a number of different ways. Let's take a look at this year's celebrations. Feminism is not about making women strong. Women are already strong. It's about changing the way the world perceives that strength. As the world is ascending towards new developments and advancements with every rising sun, the role of women in paving the path towards a better and a more progressive future cannot go unmentioned. To honor these young unsung women, International Women's Day was celebrated all over the country in a number of different ways.
महिलाएं वो सब कुछ कर सकती है जो पुरुष कर सकते हैं. हमेशा जब हम महिला अधिकारों की बात करते हैं या फिर रिजर्वेशन की बात करते हैं, हमें हर एस्पेक्ट पे काम करना चाहिए.
In the northeastern city of Agartala, a Women's Day march was carried out by young girls from a number of different schools to mark the day and embrace the strength of womanhood. In a similar show of courage and valor, women in western city of Mumbai also took part in a bike rally. Dressed in white kurtis and orange turbans, a number of women rode motorbikes from across the streets of Mumbai, giving out the message of courage and firmness.
We definitely should remember, thank at least one day in a year. It has to be round the year, but like birthdays are celebrated once a year. This day is very special to celebrate the women in our lives, to remind us that women are very important and very special, and they should not be taken for granted. Also, with this ride, we would support the message of United Nations for this year, that is Choose to Challenge.
This beautiful sand artwork is prepared by female sand artists on the shores of Puri Beach in Odisha. Six female sand artists, Subhashri Mishra, Barsa Priya Darshini, Sasmita Sahu, Sonita Das, Madhushmita Das, Vijay Lakshmi Dash from Sudarshan Sand Art School, created a unique sand sculpture to pay tribute to all the women in the world. On the other hand, the city of Taj, Agra, found another way to pay tribute to women on this special day. On that day, entries to the iconic Taj Mahal was free for women visitors.
आज 8 मार्च है, अंतर्राष्ट्रीय महिला दिवस है, और मैं तो बस घूमने आई थी इधर, और इधर आने के बाद पता चला है कि आज वो महिलाओं के लिए फ्री में टिकट है और घूमने का मौका मिला है. मुझे ये देखकर बहुत अच्छा लगा है.
International Women's Day is celebrated on 8 March every year to commemorate the cultural, political and socio-economic achievements of women around the world. Men and women show their love and respect for women in a number of different ways. Land of accumulated faiths, India is famous around the world for its ability to encapsulate different religions and beliefs under a single roof. A number of examples could be found in every nook and corner of the country, which showcases this unbreakable bond of its citizens. And recently, a similar example was seen in Haridwar city, where Muslims welcome Hindu saints ahead of the Kumbh Mela.
Ash smeared and dreadlocked saints on foot and horses have started gathering on the banks of River Ganges to participate in the famous Kumbh Mela. In a gesture to showcase the brotherhood and amiable bond between different religious communities, Muslims welcomed Hindu saints with garlands in their hands and smiles on their faces.
ये जो हरिद्वार के लिए पेशवाई निकली, इसमें जगह जगह मुस्लिम समाज के लोगों ने जगह जगह स्वागत के लिए स्टॉल लगाए, जगह जगह स्वागत समारोह रखे हैं। ये समारोह इसलिए हैं ताकि हमारे हिंदुस्तान की एकता को बढ़ावा मिल सके, हिंदू मुस्लिम भाईचारे को बढ़ावा मिल सके और ये एकता हमारी कायम रहे।
It is through gestures like these that the bonhomie between citizens of different religious groups is showcased and the message of unity in diversity comes out loud.
ये मुस्लिम समाज के द्वारा एक पहल की गई है जो कि पूरे भारत को एक संदेश है भाईचारे का। मैं मानता हूँ सभी को मिलजुल कर एक होकर इसी तरह से एक दूसरे का स्वागत करना चाहिए और सहयोग करना चाहिए।
The Kumbh Mela is one of the largest religious gatherings around the world. Celebrated in a cycle of 12 years, this fair is held on four riverbank pilgrimage cities in India, which are Allahabad, Haridwar, Nasik, and Ujjain. This year, the Kumbh Mela is being organized in Haridwar city with fresh restrictions on people's movement, along with keeping night curfews in view of coronavirus cases.
Now a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
Jammu and Kashmir is marketing its winter and cultural tourism to help the industry recover in the post-COVID-19 world with a tourism festival. A lesser-known village, Doodhpathri, was chosen as the host to the three-day tourism festival in the picturesque valley to promote offbeat destinations for tourists apart from popular destinations like Gulmarg, Pahalgam and Srinagar.
बाकी डेस्टिनेशंस में गुलमर्ग हो, पहलगाम हो, सोनमर्ग हो, काफ़ी अच्छा रश रहा, लेकिन जैसे जहाँ इस वक्त हम लोग हैं दूधपत्री में, मुझे लगता है दिस इज़ द अमेजिंग प्लेस। बहुत ही ज़बरदस्त जगह है जहाँ गुलमर्ग की तरह, पहलगाम की तरह, सोनमर्ग की तरह खूबसूरत वादियाँ हैं, पहाड़ है, नदी नाले हैं और इस वक्त भी देखिए बर्फ़ की चादर चारों तरफ है। तो ये एक ऐसी डेस्टिनेशन है जो अभी तक उस तरीके से जो है इसकी पब्लिसिटी नहीं हुई है।
The festival showcased Kashmiri dance and music programs, local art and craft, skiing and snow-clad picturesque mountains. Tourism in Jammu and Kashmir is one of the main sources of income for the state. A forest elephant camp in India's southern Shivmoga district has a new addition in its members, a female tusker who has been brought for breeding. The new member of camp named Kaneni is aged about 20 years old and has arrived from Chitradurga district to the Sakre Bauli elephant camp which trains captive elephants.
The name of that elephant is, female elephant is Kaneni, aged about 20 years. We have brought that particular elephant for a reason of reproduction only. So we have brought it. The health of elephant is very good.
Elephants in the camps often do not accept unknown females and hence Kaneni will be kept for 2 to 3 months for the mating process. India has over 50% of world's Asiatic elephant population and the animal is highly revered in the country. Indian Navy recently commissioned INS Karanj, a Kalveri class, a diesel-electric attack-style submarine in the western port city of Mumbai. INS Karanj is the third Kalveri class submarine in an expected series of 6 under program Project 75. It is a small 60-meter submarine with strategic deployment purposes.
It is developed by India's Mezagon Dock Limited, and unlike its predecessors, INS Karanj has been developed without any supervision from French partners.
This is the third Tisri submarine which has been commissioned. The fourth one, Vela, is going through her sea trials. We have launched the fifth one, and we are then thereafter going to go for the sixth one. So all six submarines of the P-75 now in a series manner, they will keep getting commissioned.
The warship is equipped with a weapon package that includes sufficient wire-guided torpedoes and subsurface-to-surface missiles, which can neutralize a significantly large enemy fleet despite its own small size. For self-defense, it has a state-of-the-art torpedo decoy system. INS Karanj commenced sea trials in September last year and achieved maximum operating depth. The fourth submarine, INS Vela, was launched May last year and is expected to commence sea trials soon.
India is a land where Sufism has not only flourished in its true spirit, but has also become a way of integrating different religious communities. The unity of these myriad faiths can be very well witnessed at the dargahs of Sufi saints. So today we take you to Dargah of Noghaza Pir in New Delhi that has been serving as a bridge between different castes and communities. Situated in the capital city of New Delhi, the shrine of Sufi Saint Mubarak Baba Noghaz Pir Sahib has served as a cynosure of communal harmony for generations, which is thronged by a large number of devotees each day from across the nation, irrespective of their religion. Regarded as one of the greatest Sufi saints, Noghaz Pir throughout his life spread the message of Sufism and peace. Whether one is Hindu, Muslim, Sikh, or from any other community, it is believed that the saint fulfills wishes of everyone.
यहाँ पे बहुत दूर दूर से लोग आते हैं और बहुत सारी मुराद लेके आते हैं जिनको कोई भी ऊपर की प्रॉब्लम होती है या कुछ दिल में मुराद जो भी होती है वो सारी मुराद यहाँ नौगज पीर बाबा के यहाँ पे पूरी की जाती है और जैसा कि आप देख रहे हैं आपको कोई भी बाबा का या किसी भी चीज़ का प्रॉब्लम्स हो सो सारी प्रॉब्लम्स यहाँ पर सॉल्व होती है.
Located in Vajrapad area, out of the many religious sites that are present in the national capital, the Dargah of Noghaz Pir is believed to hold special significance. There is a story that the saint's height is around 27 feet tall or 9 gaj. His name is believed to be Mubarak Baba and that he ensured safe journeys and completion of all works related to betterment of humanity in his times. The shrine is regularly visited by devotees belonging to different faiths from Delhi and nearby areas. At his shrine, devotees offer a 9-foot chadar or shawl for fulfillment of wishes.
Pir Baba ke bare mein humne bahut kuch dekha hai aur pehle jab se maine yahan par aana shuru kiya hai pehle mere paas bahut garibi thi khane tak ka nahi tha. लेकिन जब से मैं यहाँ पर आया हूँ अल्लाह के करम से बुजुर्गों के दुआ से नौगजा पीर से कि मैं बहुत शांत और बहुत सुकून हूँ और जिसके बारे में कुछ सोच भी लेते हैं अल्लाह की तरफ से दुआ कर देते हैं वो भी ठीक हो जाते हैं.
The solidarity among the different religious communities has remained a hallmark for India's unity since time immemorial. And examples of religious and peaceful coexistence like these could be witnessed from the length and breadth of the country. India has a great tradition of sports. Though cricket is undoubtedly the most famous in the country, but the other indigenous sports too have not failed in retaining their popularity. In today's scenario, authorities are working around the clock to promote all kinds of sports in India. In the same line of initiatives, an archery championship was organized in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir.
The budding archers of Jammu and Kashmir hit the target with their bow and arrows as Union Territory's Jammu district hosted the 3 days archery championship. organized by the Archery Association of Jammu and Kashmir under the aegis of Jammu and Kashmir State Sports Council. The event aimed at providing a platform to youngsters to showcase their shooting skills. Around 100 archers from various districts of Jammu and Kashmir participated in the competition under different categories like mini, sub-junior, junior and senior.
हमने जम्मू कश्मीर से पार्टिसिपेशन हो रही है. पहले ये हमारे बच्चे जो थे लद्दाख से थे, ले से ले, अब वहाँ यूनियन टेरिटरी बन गई है, तो ये यूटी के बच्चे हैं यहाँ पे जो पार्टिसिपेट कर रहे हैं.
डेटिंग बैक टू वैदिक पीरियड, आर्चरी कंटिन्यूड टू बी प्रैक्टिस्ड इन द इंडियन पैलेसेस टिल द एंड ऑफ द 19th सेंचुरी. In the modern times, it has already made its way to various national and international sports events, giving the country a number of eminent players like Muskan Kirar, Dola Banerjee, Deepa Kumari and Rahul Banerjee. Even at state and district level, a number of archery competitions are organized to bring young talents to the fore. Such competitions not just help these enthusiasts to hone their archery skills, but also motivate them to make their career in this sport.
मुझे मतलब जो हमारे कोच थे उन्होंने पूरा मोटिवेट किया था, बताया था सब कुछ, तो फिर मैंने सोचा कि करके देखते हैं. फिर धीरे धीरे इंटरेस्ट हो गया, फिर करते गए. मैंने खेलो इंडिया में पार्टिसिपेट किया था, मेरी फर्स्ट रैंक थी और स्कूल नेशनल में मेरे 4 गोल्ड मेडल हैं और भी सीनियर जूनियर नेशनल बहुत सारे में पार्टिसिपेशन है मेरी.
धीरे धीरे करते गए, स्टेप बाय स्टेप करते गए. स्टेट मैचेस खेले, ले में हुए थे, वहाँ 3 गोल्ड मेडल आए. थोड़ा मतलब इंस्पिरेशन आने लगी कि हाँ आर्चरी अच्छी हो रही है. फिर नेशनल खेला था, नेशनल इंडोर मेडल आया, सिल्वर मेडल आया था. वहाँ से थोड़ा इंस्पायर हो के फिर मैंने आर्चरी मतलब अच्छे से बिल्कुल करने स्टार्ट कर दी. आज की चैंपियनशिप में सर मैं बड़ी देर से प्रैक्टिस कर रहा हूँ.
Requiring surprising amount of strength and stamina and great powers of concentration and technique, archery, which was historically used for hunting and combat, has today successfully made its name in various competitive sports.
Next, we bring you a few short stories about the recent developments and happenings from around the world in our new edition, World in Focus.
In Japan, convenience is king, and getting tested for COVID-19 can be highly inconvenient. Offering a solution for a range of necessities in Tokyo is the vending machine. By selling test kits, these vending machines provide consumers with an option to avoid crowded clinics or having to wait for an appointment. Until now, 7 such machines have been set up in the greater Tokyo area.
まあ、密を解消して予約もいらなくて、手軽に検査を受けられる方法として、自動販売機があちこちの町にあればすごく便利なんじゃないかなというふうに、思いついて自動販売機の開発を始めました。
Each vending machine holds about 60 testing kits which sell for 4,500 yen or $40. Customers then mail off a saliva sample for processing. An app aimed at tracing patients infected with COVID-19 or those who have come into contact with them has been launched in Saudi Arabia as the kingdom aims to curb the spread of the disease. Known as Tawakkalna, this app was officially launched last year as a way to facilitate the issuance of movement permits for public and private sector employees during curfew, but was further developed and relaunched with updated features.
صراحة نحن من بعد تطبيق توكلنا من خلال هاي السنة صار في عنا وعي أكبر, صار في ببين مين كان معه كورونا أو لا, مين كان يعني سوى, صار في أمان أكثر هاي السنة. السنة الماضية لما إجا كورونا كان شوي مخيف الوضع, هلأ لا صار قلت الحمد لله الحالات وصار أفضل, صار في تنظيم أكثر مع نظام توكلنا.
The application has been developed to identify people infected by the virus, people who have been in quarantine or those who have been vaccinated.
Citizens are required to use the app to gain access to public spaces such as malls and restaurants in the capital. A group of actors dance in a ring of ultraviolet light projected onto a square in Rotterdam from a glowing black orb suspended above them. Able to forget the pandemic for a short while, they wear no face mask and do not observe social distancing rules. Dutch designer Daan Roos Garde's urban sun installation harnesses ultraviolet light to reduce the amount of coronavirus in the air in busy spaces and lessen the risk of transmission.
Well, the interesting of the SAFAR UVC 222 nanometer light is that you cannot see it with the human eye. Yeah, so the inner center is 99.9% virus free, and we made it sort of surrounded by visual light so you can see where it's safer or not safer. And I think, I really became inspired by using design, using science to create places which are safer instead of being stuck in the Zoom screen all the time.
The pandemic has led to a boom in interest in UVC or ultraviolet light in wavelengths of less than 280 nanometers, an effective killer of the coronavirus and other viruses. Roos Garde, who blends science and design in his projects, created the Urban Sun after studies that suggested ultraviolet light in the 222 wavelength, slightly less than the industry standard, is generally safe. His concept is to use visible light shining above the black orb to illustrate where the invisible ultraviolet light is present, directly underneath. The effect is a little like an eclipse.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at myindia@anin.com. Now we'll leave you with the visuals of this year's Mahashivratri celebrations, the most auspicious Hindu festival dedicated to Lord Shiva. I'm your host, Skyrim, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.
Subscribe TAG TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.